Hey, what's up? I'm Eric here. There's an Android phone on the left, and you see ESP32 TTGO on the right. Once it's connected to the Android phone via USB cable, the app will open and receive a random key from ESP32. And then click confirm to go to the next page. This project is to create a hardware key that works with the app. Of course, you need to create an application too. Let's say you have to make a very special app. This app should not be operated with the hardware key. Anyone can run the app, but you absolutely need the hardware key to get the second page, which is the main page. If you remove the key from the phone, it forces you to the first page. It means that the key is absolutely necessary for the app to run normally. Although this is not useful at all in normal circumstances, it can be used in very special cases. This video will cover only the ESP32 TTGO part, and the next video will cover the Floro app. Let's get started. I have updated the digital rain animation library introduced in the previous video. The current version is 1.1.0, and today's project requires this version. In this version, I modified and added the code to the generate and random keys and showing on the screen. Download through the link below and install it directly from Arduino IDE. Unfortunately, it's not yet available for download through the library manager. It's installed. Let me open one of the examples from this library. Go to File, Examples, Digital Rain Animation, Demo Generating Random Key. This project is based on the task of FreeRTOS. The reason why I separated the display output and the input from the user is to eliminate the momentary delay. I will explain this part later. When a user enters a specific keyword key into the serial com, it invokes the getKey function of the digital rain anim library. Then this library creates a random key made up of alphabets and returns it. It's printing it out in serial and done. Otherwise, when a string other than the key is received, the function to make the key empty is called. There is nothing in the loop because everything works on each task. Okay, then let's start while seeing the screen. After the upload is done, please open your serial monitor. On the right, you can see the connected ESP32 TTGO. Let me enter the keyword key ? On the serial monitor. As soon as it was entered, the screen changed from green to red and got 13 random alphabets. Did you notice? The first letter in each row of the ESP32 screen is a randomly obtained key. If you read the white letters in order, it's the same characters as the printed one in the serial monitor. It allows you to hold the key for 1 minute when it's created and automatically removes the key after 1 minute to return its original state. It's basically idle when it's green. When it's red, it means you have the generated key. If you want to go back to the idle mode before 1 minute, just enter any key. That's it. I will wait to see if we can really go back to the idle mode in a minute. As I said, it went back to the idle. I will enter the keyword again. What you should be careful about here is whether there is a delay on the screen when I enter the key. You can see that no delay has occurred in the animation while getting messages from serial communication. Let me show you how there is a delay. Let's put the task-based code for animation and key input into the loop. This is also required if you are using the Arduino board not supported by FreeRTOS. It's the same code, so I will copy it quickly and complete it. The animation is coming out well without any delay. Then let's enter the keyword here. Did you see it now? You can see the animation stop for a moment. Let's enter any key to switch to idle at this time. You can see that it stops momentarily and then progresses again. It's not a big deal though, but it bothers me. This is why I wrote the program based on the task. That's it for today. In the next video, we will complete the Floro app. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.